Hey, everybody. It is Sunday, December 20th, and this is day 37 of Mike TV Live, 40 shows in 40 days. And I will be joined in the studio by my lovely girlfriend, Katie, in just a bit. I think she's downstairs getting in one last cigarette before she comes and joins me here. So I was saying in the sort of pre-show, talking to a handful of people in the chat, and I was saying that... That I think on show 39, which will be in 2 days, which will be on, I guess, Tuesday, I will sort out the rules. I want show 40 to be a drinking game. In fact, right now I'm in the process of uploading all of the past. I didn't realize I had like almost 10 shows that I hadn't yet uploaded to YouTube. So I'm uploading them in batches of five. So I'm gonna get the first five done tonight, and they'll be available. So I think that might include the one where I was drunk, which was really silly. But anyway, so I was saying, so the show 40 is gonna be a drinking game, and so it's gonna be something like, if I fuck up, then I drink, and if I can make it through a song without fucking up, then you guys drink, or you know, like we'll figure out whatever rules, but we'll kind of bandy them back and forth and sort them out, and then we'll figure it out. So. Cool. And spiders are your friend, Shandy. So Shandy says, if I disappear, it's because the spiders in my flat have eaten me. I don't know where they've come from. Spiders are your friends. They kill all the other insects for you. They actually work overtime to make sure that your place is bug free, except for the spiders. So if you can wrap your head around the fact that you have to cohabitate with spiders, they'll definitely keep, you know, all the other bugs away, which is nice. I like spiders. I like it when I see spiders doing their job. All right. Oh yeah, yeah, and I am gonna have. What I think I'm gonna do. Hey, Paul, good to see you, man. What I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually have the chat as a separate thing, so I can go just to the chat, so I can show people what they're saying, And then I'll also have one where the chat will be kind of half the screen, and I'll have one where it's just like this. So I think for just like this, while I'm playing the music, and I can actually set that up. I can actually have the rules below running, you know, at the bottom of the screen right here, like right here in this area. So anyway, so yeah, we'll sort it all out, but we'll make it all happen. But all right, so let me get up and running. So this is a song that I hadn't played in forever and ever and ever. I played it yesterday. It's a lot of fun, and so I decided I wanted to play it again tonight. Let me get the song out of the way, and then we'll talk a little bit in a bit. So here we go. Wait. I think I need my capo. Nope. Oh, there we go. Okay, here we go. It was in the wrong key. Here we go. Every kiss she gives is like a drug, and I'm an addict addicted to her love. And every time that she leaves, I feel the most ferocious need. I need her love, I need her love, I need her love, I need, I need, I need. Every time I take her to my room, my heart, it can't contain the joy that blooms. And I fall down to my knees, and through my ears, my brain, it bleeds. I need her love, I need her love, I need her love, I need, I need, I need the heat of her body next to me. Oh, she loves me, and it's for her that I wrote this song I sing. Oh, she loves me, and it's through love I can do most anything. Heart should know the joy I know. It would put an end to soldiers were it so. Cause there's no room to fight when you're loving through the night. I need her love, I need her love, I need her love, I need the heat of her body next to me. Oh, she loves me, and it's for her that I wrote this song I sing. Oh, she loves me, and it's through her love I can do most anything. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Yum 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 yum. Every kiss she gives is like a drug, and I'm an addict addicted to her love. And every time that she leaves, I feel the most ferocious need. I need her love. I need her love. I need her love. I need her love. Oh, her love is all I need. Ooh.
Hey, awesome, Jamie. How's the tattoo happening? What's Jamie? Is the tattoo like a birthday present to yourself? You can answer that in the 30, the 40 seconds after it happens, after it gets to you. And let me see. So I was saying, this set is going to be, so I've got an album that is available on Bandcamp, but it's actually going to hit stores across the planet. My hope is before the new year. I'm just super broke right now, and so I'm really struggling to take care of my personal life financial needs and the record label's financial needs, but if all things work out, then yeah, it'll be out before the 31st. I wanted it out before Christmas, but I just don't know if that's gonna be possible. But it's called True Crime Television, and so I figured I would just play a bunch of songs from True Crime Television because I forgot there's some really good tunes on it. And so so this is basically the song that's sort of the single on Bandcamp, and it goes like this.
If only love was a bomb, I'd be bombing everyone. If love was a hurricane, I'd fly it over everything. I know I'm packed full of love, from my hair to my heels. If only love was wildfire, I'd burn down the fields. I can't put it into words the way I feel about you, darling. These are words that could express it best. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. Carpet bomb you with my love. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love. I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love. If only love was a ring, I would put it round your finger. If love was a murderer, I'd certainly let it linger. I'm packed full of love, from my toes to my crown. If only love was King Kong, I'd never put you down. I can't put it into words the way I feel about you, darling. These are words that could express it best. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. Carpet bomb you with my love. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love. I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love. Just for you. 3,000 megatons. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. Drop it by me with my love. I'm gonna bomb you with my love. I'm gonna explode.
3,000 megatons of love, I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love, I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love, I'm gonna explode. 3,000 megatons of love. So what is going on in chat? It looks like there is some explosions of some sort. Basically, yeah. So I ask you guys, you know, just please be respectfully of each other and what have you. But yes. So anyway, so that's basically the single off of True Crime Television, which is the album that's about to come out. And it's totally missing the anyway, there's a really cool piano line that I obviously can't play because I'm playing the guitar simultaneously, but you know, on over the chorus. So yeah, I dig it. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep playing. So this is a song. You know, I actually played this yesterday, but it's from True Crime Television. So I figured I'd play it, and it's a good tune. And and it's a good one. Here we go. And I'm playing it in C sharp in case you want to play along. If those of you, if you've got a guitar, it actually is the recorded version's in C, but I moved it up to C sharp because it's a little bit easier for me to sing. Shelly was exhausted and she never ate dinner, cause she worked two jobs and could never fit it in her schedule. Shelly rubbed her belly cause she knew that she was late again. She said a little prayer and went back to a tiny section. She was gonna be a movie star someday, at least that's what she thought when she moved to LA. But all she wants right now is 24 hours of sleep. All she wants to do is keep up with the bills and the rent and the high price of gasoline, and all she wants to do is keep up with the price of diapers and the cost of everything, and all she wants to do is keep up with the car so filthy and the dishes are the never done, and all she wants to do is keep up, cause there's nowhere to go, nowhere that she can run. Shelly's youngest baby got some sort of infection, so she waited at the clinic, but the minutes they kept adding up, and 3 hours later her baby got some medicine and she got written up for showing up late again. She was gonna be a movie star someday, at least that's what she thought when she moved to LA. But all she wants right now is 24 hours of sleep. All she wants to do is keep up with the bills and the rent and the high price of gasoline, and all she wants to do is keep up with the price of diapers and the cost of everything, and all she wants to do is keep up with the car so filthy and the dishes, oh they're never done, and all she wants to do is keep up, cause there's nowhere to go, nowhere that she can run. There was a murder-suicide today in Echo Park. A mother of two toddlers, it breaks our heart. But we know that she was evil, and we know that she was wrong. And we ask everybody to stay strong. All you need to do is keep up with the bills and the rent and the high price of gasoline, and all you need to do is keep up with the price of diapers and the cost of everything, and all you need to do is keep up with your car so filthy and the dishes are the never done, and all you need to do is keep up, cause there's nowhere to go, nowhere that you can run. Okay, so what's going on, guys? It seems a little bit like we might have a troll or two. So I'm gonna ask the people that are my regulars, if everything's cool and everybody's hunky dory, then that's awesome. If there is a troll, if you guys can just identify who the troll is, I will squash him. Okay. All right. So here, I'll do this. I'll put somebody on timeout. I'm not gonna ban him, but I'm just gonna time him out for a little bit. Sorry, brother. I just think that we need to put you on a little timeout. There you go. Okay. Did that do it? I don't even know. I clicked it. Okay. All right. Oh, yeah. Okay, good. I did it. There we go. All right, good. All right. So, that's cool. Thank you so much. I feel bad. I mean, I want everybody to have a good time, and I don't even mind some bickering and some silliness between people. I don't even mind like people just being silly, but I just, you know, I just want everybody to be, you know, friendly and have a good time. And so, all right, let's see. Cost of everything. So this is really funny. So this next song is probably the most personal song I've written actually about my personal life. Like, I mean, that my personal growing up years, but the thing is like, I have a terrible relationship with my father So all of these lyrics actually do speak specifically to people. And I don't know why I felt important to say that, but I just think that like, sometimes I'm like, God, this song really breaks me up. And then I'm like, I wonder why it doesn't resonate with people the same way. And I'm like, well, cause it happened to me. And so anyway, here we go. Okay. Oh, wait, hold on. Give me 1 second. I'm going to make Katie, I'm going to give you the ability to like, to police the chat, if that's okay.
Yeah, sure.
Is that cool? All right, give me 1 second. So sorry about this. So for those of you watching the recording version of this, you're gonna be like, this is awesome. But what I'm doing is I'm just making it, okay. Cool. All right, great. So if you go to the viewer list, where the viewer list is, and then you just click on a name, if you left click on the name, it'll give you options, and then that you can do. Okay. So let me see. So let me see what we're saying. Yeah, I can play stuff from Ordinary World a little bit later on. Father, are you bothered that I never care to call? I guess you never bother cause you don't call at all. I guess maybe it's true what they say about you. You're only as good as the people you use. Mister, will you kiss her when she says she has to leave? And she's never coming back cause she's taking off with me. And we'll take in the sights, we'll stay out all night. And we'll never look back, looking left to the western lights. Oh, the love that you keep hidden is a love that no one sees, and the love you've never given is a love you don't receive. Lovely little lady, oh, why so full of rage? I know that things are hard, but there's a better way. Sure, life is unfair, but the children are scared and shouting all day. Well, that's just gotta wear you down. Oh, the love that you keep hidden is the love that no one sees. Shit. And the love you've never is a love you don't receive. All me, myself, and I, yes, I'm talking to you three. Well, I hope you get well soon, and please take care of me, cause I'm all that I got, and sure than not, my mind's gonna break and my heart's gonna stop. Me, myself, and I, oh, what you gonna do? You gotta love yourself if you want the others to. And I know that it's hard, and I know that you're scared, and it's better in here, so much better than out there. Oh, the love that you keep hidden is a love that no one sees. And the love you've never given is a love you don't receive. Oh, the love that you keep hidden is a love that no one sees. And the love you've never given is a love you don't receive. Yeah, Katie now has a sword but next to her name. Like, she's like Link. Link. Okay, so what are we doing? How are we? Oh, yeah, so somebody requested songs from Ordinary World. I can certainly play I know pretty much every song from that record. And even the ones I don't know, I could probably figure out. But let me do this. Let me get through my set. Just because I these are all songs that I don't play regularly, and I rehearsed them before the show, but like just that last song, I'm holding on to them. I have a very tenuous hold on them, and then when they're done, then I'll play some songs from Ordinary World. So, okay, let me see. So this one. This one, I keep vacillating over whether I should sing the little instrumental section or not, but I think I'm going to, and we'll just see. I've done it without the instrumental section. I'm going to do it with the instrumental section. We'll see. But it goes like this. Dee dee da dee dee da dee dee da la dee dee da dee dee da dee dee da dee dee da. My voice is so very small, it's a wonder that I'm heard at all. Like a fierce butterfly, I try to fly through the squall. These are a few of my words, it's a miracle they're ever heard. Like a fierce butterfly, I duke it out with the birds. And though I fight, I'll surely die. But while I fight, I am alive. So I say, let it come down. And when it's all stacked against you, and when there's nothing you can do, ooh, you can fight. So this is my tiny song. Soon enough it will be gone. Like a fierce butterfly, I take the windshield head on. Once a dream that I might live a significant life, but like all my dreams, upon waking it seems that they die. Once a chance upon hope, but hope is a very long rope, and with enough length and so little strength you will choke. But I will fight and I will die, for while I fight I am alive. So I say, let it come down. And when it's all stacked against you, and when there's nothing you can do, oh, you can fight. my tiny song. Soon enough it will be gone. Like a fierce butterfly, I take the windshield head on. Like a fierce butterfly, I take the windshield head on. Oh, so Steve said, speaking of which, I listened to Cannibalism last night all the way to the end with the munching, and now, yeah, and the scream. We actually, that scream on that was Jim, our guitar player. We're like he has this, like, ear-splitting scream, and I'm like, Jim, do it. Come on, do it, dude. Do it. Just do it. And he's like, no, I'm not going to. We finally got it to the very end. So, oh, my God. We had so much fun recording those records. Anyway, it's really funny. That's the one thing I miss. That's the one thing I miss about, like, now I'm in Austin and I'm recording all of the Gets a Ghost stuff by myself. But well, that's one of the things I really miss is just being in the recording studio with a bunch of my friends and then just coming up with stupid, silly shit to put on the records just to, like, you know, just to, like, literally just to amuse us, you know, I mean, and then hopefully it amuses you guys, but just super fun. So, So in regards to me actually physically touring, I would love to. And I know that S.A. Bach and I have been talking about doing just he and I doing a little solo tour around the country. It would actually be Katie and myself and Sebastian. And we would be traveling either as two units or three units because Katie and I can also do the Say It With A Bullet stuff. So it would kind of depend on, like, you know, where we're at and what we're doing. But the thing is it getting the full band a tour is just so, so expensive. And the thing is, like, right now, I mean, even right now, I am like constantly struggling for cash. So, which is why I'm trying to migrate from making money off of film and television licensing, which I actually, there's been some recent developments, in regards to that, that sound pretty awesome, but I don't want to talk about them until they kind of come to fruition. But the thing is that puts my livelihood in the hands of other people. Like, you know, if someone has to be like, well, you like your song and we want to license it for film and TV. That's the way I've made my living for the past 13 years for the most part. I mean, I make a little bit of money. I make a little bit of money off of album sales. And that's why I love Bandcamp, because Bandcamp, it's like, you buy an album, I make eight from Bandcamp, and if it's a $10 album, I make like $8. It's the best split, you know, you can get in town. Anyway, long story short, so the thing is that I would love to tour. I think that I might personally be able to do a tour of the country. I just need to get my finances corrected. And so what I'm doing, So I'm just focusing on music. I'm going to be doing these shows once these 40 shows in 40 days are over, which will be this Wednesday. Wednesday is the last show. I'm going to take the winter break off. I'm going to go through the new year, and then sometime in the first week of January, I'm going to start these shows up again, and they're going to go Thursday. They're going to go Sunday through Thursday, and they're going to be much shorter though. They're going to be like set. I'm going to play like a 7-song set. It's not going to be like the more lengthy thing. Just because I really do like the idea that playing live for the past 40 days has really helped my live chops, has kind of made me a lot more limber in terms of my ability to, like, look at a song and be like, oh, I remember how to play this and play it. So, but anyway, so the thing is, like, so yeah, so all of that stuff, but the thing is, like, and then I'm trying to figure out ways in which to monetize the music, you know, like, and in fact, we'll talk about, let me get back to music. We'll talk about this in a little bit later on. But, anyway, let's go. So this is another tune, and it goes like this. This is I want to save that. All right. So this is another song from that same album, True Crime Television, which you can actually find this album, and it's got some amazing, I mean, I really love them. I don't know if you guys love them, but there's the instrumentals on it, and I fucking love them. At least Jetpacks. I really love Jetpacks. But anyway. So this is a song from that.
Mistakes were made. I know that for a certainty. We were never meant to walk alone. But every heart is hardened by hard circumstance. Everyone's got wounds now turned to stone. And we've been cast in shadows as we walk towards the light. Hand in hand we stumble through it all. And I'm so very happy that it's your hand in mine to lift me up as we stumble on. And so we fall in love. Though trouble surrounds us, yes, trouble enough. Though the storms they may rage, they can wash us away. The fire inside us burns on. Honesty's a policy, but who can say that it's better than the lives we're taught to tell? There's a place reserved for each and every one of us. It's just getting there that ends up being hell. And we've been breaking bottles against the walls of Jericho. We've been singing songs all along. And I'm so very happy that it's your voice I know will lift me up as we stumble on. And so we fall in love. Though trouble surrounds us, yes, trouble enough. Though the storms they may rage, they can wash us away. The fire inside us burns on. And so we fall in love. Though trouble surrounds us, yes, trouble enough. Though the storms they may rage, they can wash us away. The fire inside us burns on.
So, I just realized that I truncated the whole instrumental section of that song. So that was a very, very short, short version of Stumble On. Okay. But, I'll play some songs from Ordinary World. So I'll expand out this, expand out the set a little bit. So this is a song, I don't think I've ever played this song live. I might have, because I have a chord chart. The reason I can tell when I've played songs live is because there's a chord chart for them, because I literally, like, of the eight, I think I've written since I got to Austin, I think maybe about 110 songs, 120 songs. Remembering all those songs is impossible, so... Or at least without playing them regularly, which is why I like doing these shows, because it gives me an opportunity to play them all quite a bit. I have a chord chart for this one, so I know at some point in time I played it, maybe for a Ustream, I don't know, but here we go.
Life can be hard, life can be cruel. Oh, there's no rules to read. There's not much anything that turns me on anymore. But since I found you, I've turned around, and now I finally see something worth fighting for, something worth dying for, darling. But I know that there will be hard times too, 'cause life, it never seems to just go smooth. But I promise you that I will do everything that I can do. I never wanna hurt you, darling. I never wanna break your heart. I always wanna love you, lover. I never wanna be apart from you, my love, from you, my sweetheart. Some people are dumb, some people are cruel, some people are fools, you see. Some are quite miserable, and others make misery. But since I found you, I'm not doomed to be one of these. I can be better now, I will be better now, you'll see. And I know that there will be hard times too, 'cause life never seems to just go smooth. But I promise you that I will do everything that I can do. I never wanna hurt you, darling. I never wanna break your heart. I always wanna love you, lover. I never wanna be apart from you, my love, from you, my sweetheart. wanna hurt you, darling. I never wanna break your heart. I always wanna love you, lover. I never wanna be apart from you, my love, from you, my sweetheart.
Well, that one was a little bit rough. Let me see. By the way, Mike, I noticed on Patreon that it didn't take money from you right away. Rather, it takes it when you share something new. That's cool by me, but maybe a problem because I don't leave my cash in my current account because bills, you never know what's going to sting you. Is there a way to know when you will take payment? Oh, yes. All right. So basically, what they do is they actually don't charge your card until the around the 5th of the month. It did happen right around the 1st, but they keep pushing it back. So right now it's been around the 5th. It had traditionally been around the 3rd, like first started off on the 1st, and then over the past year it's been pushed back to the 3rd, and then this last month it was down to the 5th. So it's sometime around the 1st of the month is where all of that happens. Which I know, which sucks because it's like the same time that all other bills hit, you know, or at least rent and things like that, at least for me. So I'm like, great. You know, like, I'm hypersensitive to the fact that, you know, like if I had a billionaire fan and the billionaire fan was like, hey Mike, you know what? I'll give you, you know, $30,000 a year. Take $30,000 a year and just make music, put it out, do whatever. And then just give it away for free. I would be like, dude, I will do that in a heartbeat. But I don't. And so the thing is, and so I know that I've got a bunch of, you know, I've got a bunch of fans and friends that you know, that are, like me, you know, live, you know, hand to mouth. And so I definitely, you know, like, so yeah. So if you have to like adjust your pay, if it turns out that, you know, like you're, you know, like, it, you know, any one of you, I'm saying, if it turns out that, you know, like you were able to contribute for a few weeks and then not, or like for a couple months and then weren't able to the following months, that's totally fine. Like, I get it. Like, I won't obviously take care of yourself first, but if you can help me out, that's awesome because it definitely does help me kind of pay my bills and survive and keep the music happening. Okay. So let me see. Well, let me actually play. So that's all of the songs from True Crime Television that I was gonna play. So who requested songs from Ordinary World and what songs would you like to hear from Ordinary World? Yeah. How do I? El Dieter? Are you still watching? Do you have any songs from Ordinary World that you'd like to hear? Yep, still on. So maybe a little bit away from the thing. So let me here, you know, I'll play a song I haven't actually played in a long time from Ordinary World. It's the title track. It goes like this.
Another job today. We showed up drunk and 40 minutes late. It was his last mistake. Peter drank all through the day. Another drink to numb away the pain. But the day remained. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, 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 another ordinary day in an ordinary world with ordinary boys fucking ordinary girls in an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you. Mary got got knocked up again. She got drunk and slept with her best friend.
Fuck.
Mary didn't know what to say, because she knew that her best friend was gay. She fucked him anyway. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. In an ordinary world with ordinary boys fucking ordinary girls in an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you. Into his car, filled up the tank, and fled to foreign parts with a broken heart. Mary is a single mom. She loves her son, but laments the life she lost. She bears a heavy cross. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, 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 another ordinary day in an ordinary world with ordinary boys fucking ordinary girls in an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you.
A little odd too, but anyway, whatever. That's fine. Good enough for government work.
And I am the government.
All right. So, well, you know, man. That's you know, that's is that by design, Paul? Is that what you're saying? Ain't nobody fucking me. Never mind, ordinary girls. And then an unhappy face, which that's exactly it, dude. Cause you do know that there's a ton of resources if you just want the sex, man. It's the relationship that ends up being a little bit more difficult. A song about bears for Paul. I can do a song about bears for Paul. I do know a song about, thank you, sir. All right, so, let me think. Oh, yeah, that's right. You are Justin, because don't you do stuff for the Park Service or something? I know we've talked about it in the past.
Yeah,
and
Bernie does.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay, but yeah, because there's so much lag, I'm just gonna make some music. So, I can do.
Guts yourself beneath your clothes, a secret wound that no one knows.
knows. She likes the way she hurts herself. She makes her feel like nothing else. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. She never talks to anyone. She hides away, abhors the sun. She keeps her heart within a box, protected with 100 locks. It's true. It's true. She walks nude throughout her room. She bears the scars of countless wounds. They multiply upon her flesh. Some are old and others fresh. It's true. And the moonless night when all of the lights are gone and only darkness shines. She loves the night when only the darkness shines. She loves the night, the starless and the moonless night when all of the lights are gone and only darkness shines. She loves the night when only the darkness shines. She cuts herself beneath her clothes, a secret wound that no one knows. Likes the way she hurts herself. It makes her feel like nothing else. Dun-dum, bum-ba-dum, bum-ba-dum, bum-ba-dum. She never talks to anyone. She hides away, abhors the sun. She keeps her heart within a box, connected with 100 locks. It's true. Starless and the moonless night when all of the lights are gone and only darkness shines. She loves the night, the starless and the moonless night when all of the lights are gone and only darkness shines.
Man, I really wish we had gotten a recording of that song with Eric on the viola. I think we did. Because it's a piano. Yeah, so the ending of that song on the recorded version is the piano out. And Eric actually did his own like viola interpretation when he and I were playing it. And absolutely, man. I'm bummed that we didn't record it, but I'm glad. Thank you for requesting these songs cuz I haven't played them in a while, and it's fun to play. So I want to interject. Let me see. I'm not going to get into what's going on in the chat, but I do think it's awesome. Let me see. Were there any other songs that you wanted to hear from Ordinary World? All right, so I don't know. Let me think. What am I gonna do then? I love the whole album. The only song I don't really care for is "Die Motherfucker Die," and the only reason for that is it showed up is when I showed it to my SO. She played it nonstop. Suicide. I can do Suicide.
I've been thinking about drinking Drain. Now a nice big glass to make all my pain go somewhere else, somewhere I can find it. And I've been thinking about eating bullets, a sweet, sweet feel of the trigger as I pull it and bury a bullet somewhere deep inside. Suicide. 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 I've been contemplating hanging a kick of the chair, and my feet are dangling, and all of my worries disappear tonight. And I've been stumped on the thought of jumping, how high must I climb for a fatal dumping of all of my worries and woes over the side. Suicide. 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 There's no more reason to cry. Oh, suicide. 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 Somewhere else, somewhere I can't find it. Oh, suicide. 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 All right, yeah, I can do here. Why don't I do this? Why don't I get two more requests? So I'll do, or now one more request. I will do Crying Shame. Although I have to express with a caveat. I'll play with a caveat that I haven't played that song in a while. I'm not 100% certain if I remember how to play it. And you're right, I haven't played every song from Ordinary World over these 40 days. I can do what I love about you. That's a good one. But I think the only songs from Ordinary World that I haven't played on these shows are The Old Ennui. And the thing is, the reason why I didn't play that song is because traditionally that song is way, 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 way too high for me to sing nowadays. But I think that my voice might have recovered enough from smoking that I might be able to hit it. So I will attempt to tackle that tomorrow. And then My Wasted Life, which is like, I just think that song without the counterpointing vocal melodies, it just kind of loses a lot of its oomph. So I haven't played The Old Ennui, My Wasted Life, and I think that those are the only songs from Ordinary World. I was reviewing it the other day. I think those are the only two that I have yet to play from that record. Wait. There is nothing that I could say that would in almost any way express the frustration in my head. I don't want to get out of bed today. I don't want to face another day. Everything is better left unsaid. 'Cause I don't want to get a job. I've stolen all that I could rob. I don't know how I will get by. Something in me thinks I've won too many drinks. I don't know. I think I've spent too much time getting high. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. What do you do when you're done with living, but you are still alive? I don't want to kill myself, but I just can't survive. Hey, hey, hey. It's a crying shame. 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 I'm sick of doing anything, so burnt out on all the songs I sing. I just want to disappear. I'm too lazy to even fall asleep, lying here, not counting any sheep, listening to the passing of the years. And I don't want to get a job, I've stolen all that I could rob. I don't know how I will get by. Something in me thinks I've had one too many drinks. I spent too much time getting high. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. What do you do when you're done with living, but you are still alive? I don't want to kill myself, but I just can't survive. Hey, hey, hey. It's a crying shame. Hey, hey, hey. It's a crying shame. Hey, hey, hey. It's a crying shame. Hey, hey, hey. It's a crying shame.
Something like that. Ideater asked me, I'm curious, what did the show Weeds do for Get Sicko's popularity? And frankly, I don't know. Like, that's the thing, is it, we had a ton of licenses on Grey's Anatomy. We had a ton of licenses. Oh no, we had one license on Weeds, but it was a prominent license because it was the season finale of the second season, which is arguably like the best season of Weeds. If you follow it, like, that's the most satisfying of all, you know, all those seasons, at least for me anyway. And, you know, we're like at the very end as they're taking, you know, what's his name out to die. What?
What did you call him?
Eldeater. Oh, I sorry. It looked like I'm looking, I've got a distance between the, you know, I can barely see, but anyway, so the thing is, yeah, so I have no idea what effect all of our exposure has had. We did not have the meteoric rise that like Snow Patrol sold 100,000 units before they were on Grey's Anatomy. They ended up selling a gold record after Grey's Anatomy. You know, like we didn't have that kind of like meteoric rise from our exposure on film and TV. But we're still like, you know, I mean, we got 20,000 listeners on Spotify. That's nothing to sneeze at. Like, you know, is that because of our exposure on Weeds and Grey's Anatomy and Jack and Bobby and Burning Annie and all the other myriad things that we've been licensed on? Or is it, I don't know. I try to keep myself out there and try to keep myself, keep the music out there. And I just don't know. I wish, you know, but yeah, it's really funny. I feel like I'm in quicksand and I will at some point in time die. And I will at some point in time, like, be smothered by the sand. So I'm just trying to, like, A, stay afloat for as much as possible, and then throw out as many songs as I possibly can. And so, you know, whatever. It's good. It's a fun dynamic.
Okay, so here I'm gonna play this song. This is Justin's request, and then I'm gonna play this song, and then I'm gonna close with the Dying Stars, and that'll be it. And then we will do this again tomorrow. When we're getting pretty near the end, of the 40 shows in 40 days. So that's pretty exciting for me. I love doing these shows. In fact, I think I might try to do something between Christmas and New Year's, just a little like holiday special thing. I've been trying to wrap my head around it. So here we go.
I love your vagina. I love the flavor of your lips. I love your vagina. I love the acquiescence of your tits. I love your vagina more than words can say. You keep a miracle between your legs. I love everything about you. I love everything about you. It's true. I love everything about you, but most especially. I love your vagina, Jesus. I love the flavor of your lips. I love your vagina. I love the acquiescence of your tits. I love your vagina more than words can say. You keep a miracle between your legs.
Shit, I remember how that goes. I don't remember how this one goes.
I love your vagina. I love the flavor of your lips. I love your vagina. I love the acquiescence of your tits. I love your vagina more than words can say.
Between your legs. I have no idea why I. Between your legs. I have no idea why I can't remember how that. Between your legs, that bridge section goes.
Keep your legs. You keep a miracle.
Yeah, that song is. It's in name only. It's the last song on our very first record. So You've Ruined Your Life. Actually, the real last song is Wait, which is arguably our most popular song, which is really silly because it totally does not even fit with the record, and it's sort of a hidden track, which it's really funny. I think our record label blames the fact that I made it a hidden track on that record, blames that for us having lackluster sales of that album, and I'm like, no, you guys could have very well have made it apparent that, you know. But maybe, I don't know, maybe not, I do sort of think that. But anyway, so, that's exactly it. The thing is, like, so what Steve just mentioned, the drinking game categories, natural derail and derail due to chat, that's exactly the kind of stuff that we're going to sort out on. So we're going to do that. We're going to sort that out on Tuesday. So if you want to be part of the rules making, if you're going to be involved, you have to bring booze. And I just want to see what L. Dieter said.
I asked because I first heard of you on Weeds. I thought the song was hilarious, so I looked it up and listened to the rest of the album and had to buy it. Then my external hard drive took a shit, and I had to buy it again last year. Well, I'm sorry. I'm bummed that you had to. If ever your hard drive craps out again, you can just reach out to me at getsetgoer@gmail.com, and I'll okay. And I'll shoot you over a copy. So, all right, Jordan, brother, that was awesome, man. Good to see you. Thank you. I'll talk to you tomorrow. And let me do my little spiel real quick. So, when I moved to Austin in May of 2014, I actually started writing songs, and I actually put together a Patreon thing because my friends in a podcast called NSFW, or not NSFW, I just saw that a podcast called Night Attack. They used to be called NSFW, now it's called Night Attack. They actually had a Patreon thing going, and it was wildly successful. And so, and I was like, "Oh, that's great!" So I'm gonna. So I was like, "I'll see if I can't do something similar." And mine is dramatically less successful, but it is. There's like I think 110 people right now that are actively keeping me alive and keeping me in my place while I write and record music and while I do these shows and all of the stuff that I actually do. So if you want to be a part of that, if you want to be on the bleeding edge of my music and receive everything literally hot off the presses as I write it, all of the demos, all of the everything, you can just go here and sign up and you'll get absolutely everything. And you can do it for as little as 10 cents a week. If you want the finished products and you don't want to like be flooded with all of the hundreds of songs that I'm going to write over the next, you know, 6-8 months, then just go to Bandcamp. If you want, and you can pick up pretty much anything, everything except for the first four albums, because those are owned by our former record label. But Bandcamp has all the has all the Square Tire Records stuff, which is the label I own. And then if that doesn't work for you, if you don't like Bandcamp, you can actually go to any one of these sites, and this is where you can find it. This is all the places that gives us worldwide distribution across the planet. And then this is where you can actually catch all the archive shows. So if you like this show and you want to watch it again, it'll probably be up on YouTube over the next couple of days. And then this is the last thing I'm going to do for tomorrow's show is at 9:30 p.m. Just to allow me, because we've got band practice tomorrow. So you're gonna give me about an hour after band practice to kind of like get all set up. But so that's it. That's it. That's all the promotion stuff. And I love you guys, and I love you. I was gonna say, I noticed on Spotify breaks out the top five cities where you're being listened to, and there's like, you know, and we've got like, I think like 300 or 400 people in Mexico City that are listening to us, and so, you know, and then maybe about 100 less in London, and like, so if there's some way at some point in time, if these services start allowing us to drill into those people and reach out to them, the thing is like I think that we're getting to a point where there's going to be a confluence of information where I can reach out and be like, okay, I can figure out these towns and these cities all across the country and all across the planet have enough people listening that we can put together a tour just playing in all of these places. And if I can reach out to those people, then we can make it happen. So even though we haven't toured as a full unit in a handful of years now, I do think that in the offing and in the not too distant future, we'll be able to do all that. So, all right, here we go. So this is my last tune. I love you all. And we'll talk. We'll see you tomorrow. But anyway.
Yes, I know it's hard, it's getting harder all the time. You put your back against the wall and brace yourself and push with all your might. But nothing's moving, nothing's going anywhere. And you shove till you're exhausted, throw your hands up and you cry out in despair. But don't you ever give up. No, don't you let it get his claws into you. There's other motherfuckers, oh, what do they do? So let's crack open a bottle and let us tune
up our guitars and let us sing to the dying of the stars. Oh, let us sing for the songs that never get heard. Let's set it on fire and watch it burn. Oh, sing with me, make the heavens tremble with a song, 'cause sooner than later we'll be gone. There's thieves and liars everywhere you turn, and the more time that you spend with them, the more like them you'll become, you'll learn. And it hurts to say it, but I don't like where we've arrived, where the rich keep getting richer and the poor, well, the poor, they just keep dying. I'm just a broken songster, writing songs that no one will buy. I have no power to make it right. But here's another song, love, a song I sing with all of my heart. I know it's tough and it's falling apart. So let us sing for the songs that never get heard. Let's set it on fire and watch it burn. Oh, sing with me, make the heavens tremble with the song. Sooner than later, we'll be gone. Let us sing away the pain. Let us sing a song that makes it all okay. And if I sing a bit too long, oh, I hope you'll forgive me this song.
See you later, Paul.
Snow, it's hard, it's getting hotter all the time. You put your back against the wall and brace yourself and push with all your might. But nothing's moving, nothing's going anywhere. And you shove till you're exhausted, throw your hands up and you cry out in despair. But don't you ever give up. No, don't you let it get its claws into you. Those other motherfuckers, so what do they do? So let's crack open a bottle and let us tune up our guitars and let us sing to the dying of the stars. Oh, let us sing for the songs that never get heard. Let's set it on fire and watch it burn. Oh, sing with me, make the heavens tremble with the song. 'Cause sooner than later, we'll be gone.
All right, awesome. Thank you, guys. Good to see you all. That's awesome. So this was a lot of fun, and I'm glad to see the regulars, and I'm glad to see new people, new faces. It's awesome. And so whatever. We'll do it again tomorrow. I will see you guys all in the morrow. Cool. All right. So last night's show. Tomorrow's show is it's 7:30 Pacific, 8:30 Mountain, 9:30 Central, 10:30 Eastern. And all right. So here's the little Square Tire logo letting you know it's the end of the show. And I will see you all in the morrow. All right. Cheers.